We will quickly go over all the main concepts that you need to know on chain rule, product rule, and quotient rule, and then we will apply these concepts to solve challenging examples so you can ace your next differentiation exam. The timestamps are given below so you can easily navigate to the different sections. Let's dive in. We will start off with the chain rule, which states that if f of x equals to uv of x, then the derivative f prime equals to u prime v of x times v prime x. So basically, the chain rule tells us to differentiate the outer function u with respect to its argument v of x, keeping v of x as it is, and then multiply this by the derivative of the inner function v of x with respect to x. To better understand this one, let's have a look at a quick example. Suppose we want to differentiate f of x equals to 3x squared plus 2 whole to the power of 5. Now let's denote 3x squared plus 2 as v. Then the outer function is u of v equals to v to the power of 5. Now u prime equals to 5v to the power of 4, and v prime is equal to 6x. Then, using the chain rule, we get f prime equals to 5v to the power of 4 times 6x, and replacing v with 3x squared plus 2, we get f prime equals to 30x, open brackets, 3x squared plus 2 whole to the power of 4. Now we will quickly discuss the product rule and quotient rule, and then we will differentiate the same trig function with both these rules so you can compare and better understand each method. If you're enjoying the video so far, then please support the channel by liking and subscribing. Now the product rule states that if f of x equals to u of x times v of x, then f prime is equal to u prime v plus v prime u. So let's understand this rule with the help of this example. F of x equals to x squared over sine x. Now we first identify u of x as x squared and v of x as 1 over sine x, which is equal to sine x to the power of minus 1. Then from the product rule we know that f prime equals to u prime v plus v prime u. So u prime in this case is simply 2x. Now for v prime we can use the chain rule. So we get minus 1 sine of x to the power of minus 2 times the derivative of sine of x, which is cos of x. So v prime of x becomes minus cos x over sine of x whole squared. Therefore, f prime of x becomes 2x times 1 over sine x minus cos x over sine x squared times x squared. So we can rewrite this as a single fraction by taking a common denominator. So we get 2x sine x minus x squared cos x over sine of x whole squared. Finally, let's move to the quotient rule, which states that for f of x equals to u of x over v of x, f prime equals to u prime times v minus v prime times u whole divided by v squared. Now let's apply this rule to the previous example to see if you get the same answer in hopefully a slightly easier way. So, same as before, we set u of x equals to x squared, and in this case v of x is the denominator, sine of x. So therefore u prime equals to 2x and v prime is simply cos x. And therefore plugging in the expressions into the quotient rule, we get 2x times sine x minus cos x times x squared whole divided by sine x squared. And this of course is the same answer as what we got with the product rule, but slightly easier. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.